In this video, I'm gonna share with you 4 ways that you can raise capital for your business. I'm also gonna share the pros and cons of each of these different methods, and make sure you watch this video until the very end because I'm gonna share my personal experience raising over $1 million for my own business. Now, if you guys are new here to the channel, I help entrepreneurs take their business to the next level, and I also show investors how to invest in startup companies. So if you can make that investment in me by investing in the like button of this video, I really appreciate it. Also, make sure you smash the subscribe so you're notified at the next video. Let's go ahead and get right into it. The first way that you can raise capital for your business is through revenue. Now, I know it sounds kind of obvious, but Gary Vaynerchuk, real famous entrepreneur, has this amazing quote, make money, don't raise money. Or maybe he says, don't raise money, make money. Either way, you get the point. Basically, the best way to grow your business is organically. That way, some of the pros are you retain full ownership of the business, and that is the true entrepreneurial hustle. We're gonna talk about some of the cons of doing this in just a little bit, but a few different ways that you can actually raise revenue and raise capital for your business is simply your customers funding the operations of your business. So if you're opening a restaurant, actually sell food and people will transact through the medium of exchange that is cash, give you cash in exchange for the food. Maybe you have a software product or an app, you can actually charge your customers for the app. I will tell you, one of the biggest mistakes that I did in my own business, my swim pro, is not charging our customers soon enough. We have a mobile application. It was named App of the Year by Apple. And when we first launched, it was 100% free. We could have immediately jumped the gun and just gone ahead and charged for our customers. And we started making revenue right away. And that was a huge mistake. So a lot of times entrepreneurs think, you know what? I'm not ready to start making money yet. I need to do all these other things. Forget about it. You need to start making money as soon as possible to validate your idea and also raise cash for your business so you can reinvest and continue to grow. So simply just ask your customers. Another way that you can actually raise capital for your business through additional types of revenue is having a side hustle, simply working another job at the same time you're building your business. And sometimes this can be a distraction, which is one of the cons in doing this, but it might be the necessary thing that you have to do. So you work a 9-to-5, or maybe you work as a contractor, as a consultant, whatever it is that you do to make money so you can fund the business and grow that on the side. And the sooner you can get to working full-time and raise enough capital to do that, the faster your company is going to grow. So definitely you can do a side hustle. You can also do things that are non-core to your business to raise capital. Now, what this means, a perfect example is what Airbnb did. So everyone's familiar with Airbnb's business model, where they take a small commission off of the hosts and the people that are actually staying and exchanging on the platform. But what they actually did when they were just getting started, they actually made Serial. Yes, they actually raised capital, I think $30,000 or $40,000 at the very, very beginning. So the moral of the story is you can pivot your business only to raise capital, but you're still working on your core thing that you might be able to raise capital, raise money, raise revenue later on down the road, but do something that is not core to your actual business just to get cash in the door. Now, as you might imagine, some of the cons of doing that are you'll have slower growth if you're more organic. It might be a distraction to your core business, what you're actually trying to do. If you're working a side hustle or you're selling cereal boxes or something like that, it's distracting from what you actually want to do, but it will keep the lights on, pay the bills, and get you there in the short term. Some of the pros, obviously, you retain 100% ownership. You're not selling equity, you're not selling debt, anything like that. So you own the ship, you are captaining your own ship, and you set the direction of where you're gonna go. And that is the true entrepreneurial hustle, because you're in full control, complete control. No one can tell you what to do. And the success and failure of the business pretty much falls on you, the entrepreneur, as it should. So those are some of the pros and cons of the most simple way, which is just raising revenue. Charge your customers, make sure they pay you, deliver value. And if you deliver value, people will pay. If you're solving for a problem, people will pay in exchange for you solving that problem. So find a problem, build a solution, charge for it. And that's one way that you can raise capital for your business. Now, another way is maybe why you clicked on this video. We're talking about equity. So you can actually sell some ownership percentage of your business to someone else. That could be an individual or an institution or a lot of those or a combination. And in exchange, you can raise a lot more money a lot more quickly. Now, this is something that I've done. I've done all of these and we'll talk about that. But when it comes to equity, you could do something like friends and family round of funding. This is where you may have a wealthy relative, or maybe you just scrap together a few thousand or $100,000 from your friends, family. Maybe, you know, you've hit up your LinkedIn connections, you raise money in a lot of different creative ways, and you actually sell a percentage of your company. Maybe that's 10% of the company for $100,000. Or maybe you have a big investor like that rich uncle, and they come in and they invest $500,000, but they want to own half of the business. They want to be a true partner in building your company. So a lot of different ways that could be structured. Similarly, you could have angel investors. So this is a little bit more sophisticated professional investors that are going to each invest $25,000 for you. A number of different ways that you can actually structure this. If you guys are interested in learning more about that, make sure you subscribe to the channel. I talk about this topic a lot. And of course, similarly, you have venture capital. So rather than an individual investing in your business, you have an actual institution. So a fund, and all a fund is simply other investors have invested into that fund, and then the fund is investing in different startup companies. Very similarly, private equity. So these are big pools of money that other investors have put them all that together, and you have this big pool of money, and that big pool of money is gonna go invest in a ton of different companies. Some of the companies will go on and be very successful. Some will fail and completely be worth nothing. And so if you raise capital from that type of investment, there's different expectations that come with it. We'll talk about those in just a second. There's equity crowdfunding. This is my favorite by far. This is where you can actually raise from a lot of people all at the same time. And I've actually raised over $600,000 from over 300 investors in 36 different countries. If you guys are interested in how I did that for my company and what equity crowdfunding is all about, I'll make sure I link to a video that I did that goes in detail on how you can do that too. I also have a referral with a platform that I use called WeFunder. And if you set up a campaign, it takes like 15 minutes, you can get $2,500 off raising capital for your business. And the way this basically works, you set up a landing page and you open up the community in an open public offering, and anyone can invest. Anyone in the world can invest in your business for as little as $100. So if you already have an audience, if you have a great network, and maybe you can't raise from professional investors that are going to give you $25,000 checks, but you need to raise $100,000, $500,000, $1 million, $5 million, and you have a lot of contacts that you can reach out to and send them to that landing page and get them to invest $100, $500, $1,000, $10,000, you'd be surprised just how fast you can raise $100,000, half a million, or even up to $5 million through equity crowdfunding. So make sure you check out those links up here and down below in the description on how you can learn more about equity crowdfunding. And along those lines, there's something called a startup accelerator. This is actually a program that my company has been through a couple of these, where you basically spend 3 to 6 to 12 weeks, even more, 16 weeks in a program. They'll invest capital in your business. They'll provide coaching, mentorship, a network. And ideally you finish that startup accelerator with a demo day where you can raise even more capital from more investors. Now, I did one of these programs at the University of Michigan called the DeSci Accelerator. They were our first investor and they put in $50,000 in an equity investment. So basically by taking ownership in the company, they're making that initial investment. And most of the startup accelerators around the country and around the world will offer pretty similar terms for an initial investment, go through the program for 12 weeks, they provide mentorship, all that good stuff, and then they'll send you off to a demo day and hopefully you raise a ton more money and you go on and build your business and are really successful. So let's talk about the pros and cons of this equity type of fundraising. So the pros is that you have the highest growth potential. If you look at any of the best companies in the world, not the best companies, but the biggest companies in the world, the most profitable companies in the world, we're talking about Apple, Google, Facebook, Microsoft, Tesla. They've raised tons of money from these types of equity investments. They've also done private equity deals. They've raised billions and billions of dollars, but they started at the seed round raising couple hundred thousand dollars. Facebook's first investment was $500,000 for 10% of the company. That's now worth billions of dollars, that position in the company. And they went on to raise multiple rounds of funding. It was $12 million round. Then it was like $100-something million round. Then Facebook raised like $1.5 billion in private equity. I think Goldman Sachs was in that deal. A lot of big institutions. It all starts from what we just talked about. So you can grow very, very fast and raise a lot of money very, very quickly. And of course, that comes at the expense of selling part of your business. So when you raise the capital, it's not just free money, you have investors that actually own part of the company. Now you become liable, it's almost like a liability, in the sense that you have to report to the investors. And if the investors eventually own most of the company, like they do in a lot of the biggest companies in the world, then essentially you just become an employee of the business and they tell you what to do. Now, of course, if you're the CEO and you have strong direction and you're doing really well, everything's fine and dandy. When things don't go as planned, or maybe there's different political issues or politics of business come into play, well, they might just have to replace you because there's a board of directors. And as a CEO, it is your fiduciary responsibility to all of the shareholders. And when you raise capital, you're basically selling stock in the company, and you're gonna have shareholders that are more than just yourself, your founders, or your initial employees. So keep that in mind. It also adds that additional pressure where you are reporting and there's this expectation of growth. Big difference between raising venture capital and just raising friends and family money, or just funding the business yourself with your own side hustle. So keep that in mind if you are gonna pursue any external capital. There's also a huge time suck when it comes to investor relations. Basically, you have to keep these investors updated. You have to deliver reports. You have to deal with the questions of investors asking why you are or are not doing certain things in the business. And so that's an additional time consideration, a mental hassle that you have to deal with if you choose to do equity raises, whether it's equity crowdfunding, angel investments, or venture capital. Now let's talk about the third way that you can raise capital for your business. This is a lot more traditional. We're talking about debt financing. Debt financing is basically an IOU. You take money and you have to give it back, and you're gonna give it back on certain terms with interest most of the time. So this could be a traditional bank loan. You go to the bank, you've been in business, and now you're looking to expand. You have a track record of financials, and now you're gonna raise $100,000 to buy a new or buy a new building or buy new materials so you can expand more quickly. And then you have to pay it off in some type of an interest rate over a period of time. Now, if you know that this investment, or not investment, this debt financing will help you grow the business in the long run, and you have a lot of confidence, then this actually might be a better alternative than actually equity raises or, you know, not raising that capital at all. But sometimes there are some cons to this, but we'll get to that in just a little bit. So this is basically a private loan. You could have an investor. I wouldn't really call them an investor. I put them as an investor, where the terms of the deal from this individual investor are treated like debt. So they're giving you a big sack of cash as an individual, and they're basically serving as your financier. So they are the financier for your business. You can also do equity crowdfunding. So similar to we talked about how equity crowdfunding allows you to raise money from a lot of people all at the same time, you can do that in equity format. You can also do that as a debt instrument or a combination of both through a convertible note, which is basically a debt instrument, a debt financial vehicle, and it converts into equity when you raise more money. A little bit more complicated. I've done other videos where I talk about that, but just know that you can do equity crowdfunding as an equity investment. You can also do it as a debt financing as well. Remember, if you want $2,500 off the fees that Weef undertakes as a platform, you can set up your campaign in like 15 minutes. Make sure you check out the link down below in the description. Let's talk about the pros and cons of the debt financing model. So the pros, it's relatively straightforward. So a lot of people understand how a bank loan works, whether you're doing that for a car, a house, or a business. Ideally, you need to have some type of, you know, equity line of credit, or you have to have some line of credit or credit history so you can do this, operating financial history. Otherwise, you're not gonna be able to raise money. If you go to the bank with an idea on a napkin, they're probably not gonna give you any money. So the understanding of how this works is pretty simple. There's also no dilution. So if you raise money from a bank through a loan, the bank doesn't actually own any percentage of the business. Now, maybe through collateral, they might be able to do something if you don't pay it back, and then they can take over your business. But if you do pay it back after the loan is done and repaid and everything's fine and dandy, you still own 100% of your business, which is amazing. And that's what makes this a great form of financing for a lot of people, depending on the type of business that you're doing. Some of the cons, well, you're gonna have debt on your balance sheet. So this makes your company automatically a little bit more inferior to a company or a competitor that doesn't have any debt on their balance sheet because debt is a liability. So if it allows you to grow, that's actually good. It serves as a strategic advantage. But if you're not using the debt to grow and you just have debt on your balance sheet and you have to continue paying it off month after month, year after year, that actually hurts you. And it also takes time. It's not as quick flipping a switch to get a loan. That can take time, lengthy process. You might have to communicate with a lot of people. And oftentimes, if you're the CEO, if you're the main point person, it's you that's gonna have to deal with this, not anyone else. And that can distract you from some of the other stuff you wanna do in your company. So keep that in mind. All of these are a time suck. This one is definitely a bigger time suck, I would say, than some of the other models. Now, let's talk about grants. This is the most fun, in my opinion, but it has the biggest pros and the biggest cons. Again, my POV, my perspective on this. So you can do pitch competitions. I've won over $100,000 through pitch competitions. This is the absolute best and most creative way to raise money for your startup. Keep in mind, this takes a lot of time because most of the time when you engage in these pitch competitions, you not only have to prepare for the pitch competition and you've got to psych yourself up. Maybe you have to travel to do this. but most of the time you're not gonna win anything and you're gonna get absolutely nothing. Sure, it'll be a great experience, a learning opportunity, you meet other people, you get to refine your pitch because you'll do it over and over and over. But at the end of the day, you might walk away with absolutely nothing. So keep that in mind. Pitch competitions are a great way. I've won $50,000 in one pitch competition, $40,000 in another, $25,000 in another. It adds up, and there were a few other small ones along the way. You can also self-fund the business. So basically give a grant to yourself through your own personal savings. So this is a little bit different than, you know, a self-investment, like where you become an actual owner within the company, but literally just funneling money into the business to keep the lights on, personally financing things, right? That's certainly one way to do it. Similarly, you can do that with a friend, a relative, or something like that. You could just get a gift and you could have money gifted to your business. Again, this can take a lot of time and also puts you in an awkward situation because someone's basically giving you money and they don't own any of the business. It's not debt, so you don't have to repay it. So it's this kind of awkward situation when you do that. Of course, make sure your legal is up to par if you are just accepting money for any of these, actually. Another thing you can do is small business grants. I've gotten a few of these for my business as well. This is where you basically see different categories, like in science or technology or in the food space, and local communities and the government and different organizations will actually have grants that allow you to accept money without having to pay it back, and also without taking any ownership in the business. So this is essentially free money. It's absolutely amazing. It's like free money, and you have to apply for it, and you fill out these forms, and you might have to interview for this, and then you end up getting the money, and it's absolutely free. Now, nothing in life is completely free because normally there come terms, not terms in terms of ownership in your company, but in use of funds. So you say you're going to do something with the money and you have to actually execute on it. And normally you'll actually receive this money in tranches. So if you get $25,000, you might actually get it in five different tranches of $5,000 upon completing certain milestones. I know this is one of our grants. I believe it was $25,000. And we received it in three different tranches. I think it was 5,000, 10,000, 10,000, something like that. And you do that upon completing milestones. Now, this is a huge con actually in a lot of ways because it takes a lot of time to do this reporting. You have the uncertainty of actually getting the additional funding because what if the program decides, you know what, we ran out of money, we have to shut down. We can't continue giving you these grants that we actually promised you. And really there's no liability on the part of the granting agent because they're giving you free money in the first place. So who are you to say you can't do this? So that's something you gotta keep in mind. We've had this happen to us. And also it makes you really deviate from potentially what your initial plan was for the business. It makes it really difficult to pivot. So let's say you raise a grant on the assumption that you're going to do X, Y, and Z, but market conditions change, your knowledge of the market change, your customer profile changes, and then you can't really pivot because you're stuck to doing what you planned on doing with the use of funds in that grant. So that can be a really big liability for you as the entrepreneur and as the business, because now you have to stick with a game plan, but the course has changed. You gotta get off the expressway and you gotta turn left, but you told them you're gonna turn right. And so now you're in a really sticky situation. So definitely that's not good. So keep an eye on that. All right, let's talk about the pros and cons here. So the pros, free money. This is free money, literally no strings attached. Like I said, you know, we raised over six figures from different pitch competitions and grants and things like that. There's no debt, there's no equity, you don't have to pay it back. There's no ownership stake in the company. This is oftentimes looked at as revenue, quite frankly, on the bottom line. And you're just getting that. Now, keep in mind, there's no such thing as true free money. There's always some kind of a strings attached to that. It takes time. It takes time to do this. You might fill out 100 different applications. You might do 10 different pitch competitions and you still might not get anything. I have friends that are amazing presenters, amazing entrepreneurs. They've never won any money in a pitch competition. I also know a few other entrepreneurs that are solid at pitching, but they've raised over $500,000 through pitch competitions. So it really is hit or miss, and it's not that dependent on how good you are as an entrepreneur, as a presenter. It could come down to who's judging the pitch competition in the first place, and that's gonna determine whether or not you walk away with a $100,000 check or not. It also has to do a lot of reporting. So if you raise capital from a lot of these different methods, you will need to do a lot of reporting. And I will tell you, as an entrepreneur that's raised capital, over $1 million from over 300 investors in 36 different countries, if you can be systematic with your investor updates, it actually is not that big of a time suck. And I actually enjoy it. As you can see, I do a lot of video stuff like this for our investors. However, If that's not something that you do, you're not that organized, you don't like writing emails to investors, you don't like talking in front of a camera like this, you might want to reconsider a lot of these different options, particularly trying to get grants, because there is a lot of reporting, I would say the most reporting of any of these. And also, it can distract you from your core business. We talked about not being able to pivot. This is huge. Remember, you're driving down the road and you decide you need to take the exit on the right. Turns out, you raise capital for that assumption you're gonna go to the right. You learn that the market is telling you you need to go left, but you already raised $100,000 in a grant, and so you either decide, you know what, screw the grant, we're not gonna accept it, we're gonna return the money that we've already received, and we're gonna turn left and we're gonna do what we need to do. The grant isn't gonna like that, you are gonna be in a sticky situation, and that's one of the huge cons of accepting grant money. So I wanna make sure I remind you guys that some of the best entrepreneurs in the world have not raised any outside financing. They've funded the business 100% on revenue. So if you're thinking about it and you're deciding, you know what, I don't really wanna sell any of the company, I don't wanna have any debt on the balance sheet, I don't wanna distract myself writing grants and trying to get a little bit of money here and there, I'm just gonna build the business. Good for you, amazing. I wanna hear that in the comments. If you guys are looking to raise money, let me know in the comments how much money you're looking to raise, what are you gonna do with the funding, and I'll see and do my best to respond to everyone in the comments. Again, if you guys are looking to raise through equity crowdfunding, highly recommend it. And if you wanna see how I raised over $1 million for my business across all of these different platforms over the years and what kind of traction we had, I made a video specifically on that. I'll link it down below in the description, and I walk you through every single funding stage and how we did it. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I wish you guys the very best and keep hustling.